Hey YouTube, I'm Tristan from Smart Home Point. At the end of my previous video, I was talking through how I can install LED light strips at the bottom of my kitchen. One of the issues I had was that I had a 3 meter run, then a gap, and then a 1 meter run. So I was looking at different Philips Hue light strip options available to me, and none of the options seemed great because of this gap and the fact that I needed a 4 meter run, which meant buying multiple Philips Hue kits, and obviously they were a bit on the pricey side. So today's video talks through different options that are available to me instead of Philips Hue's own light strips. So the first thing you need to think about is whether to go for Wi-Fi or ZigBee. And I know a very prominent smart home YouTuber, Paul Hibbert, isn't really a fan of ZigBee. He basically says if you go out and buy a really expensive Wi-Fi router, then you just don't need ZigBee. Well, that is sort of true, other than the fact that you're continuously entering Wi-Fi passwords in every new device you buy. And obviously, if you change your Wi-Fi password, you're screwed because you've got to run around your house for hours, reconfiguring everything. But he is sort of correct in what he said. But for me personally, I prefer ZigBee. I don't like to have to worry about re-entering my Wi-Fi passwords all the time. I like the fact that if I buy a ZigBee device, it just works. I don't need to faff around with loads of configuration, and I can use my default router instead of going out and spending a small fortune on a really fancy router. So for me, I'm going to go with ZigBee, for my LED light strips. So what options are open to me and to you for ZigBee-based light strips? So the first option available to you and I is GLEDOPTO. And when I say that, I keep thinking of Shmoyoho, accent on the yaw. GLEDOPTO, accent on the yaw. But I won't keep saying that because it would be pretty annoying, so I'll just say GLEDOPTO. So the first option is GLEDOPTO, who mainly produce ZigBee-based controllers. So in other words, they control from the Philips Hue app or the Echo Plus side. They control signals from that into the actual LED light strip. So that's what the function of a controller is in an LED light strip. And GLEDOPTO produce a range of ZigBee-based ones, but sometimes they produce package deals as well, where, for example, on Amazon America, you can buy a GLEDOPTO USB-powered LED strip, which is 2 meters long, for around $30 or $40. I think it's $30, actually. So that's quite a cheap option compared to Philips Hue, which is more than double the price. And GLEDOPTO controllers work fairly well. In fact, when you look at when you compare their functionality to the Philips Hue's own light strips, there's actually not that much difference whatsoever. The main thing Philips Hue's light strips have going for them is the fades and the transitions between different colours and between on and off states is slightly better than GLEDOPTO's controllers. But GLEDOPTO works out less than half the price in many cases, so it's up to you whether you want to go with that option. For me, I'd probably prefer the slightly cheaper option because I'm not likely to be changing my colours frequently. If you don't have GLEDOPTO bundles available to you on your Amazon store, you may see options by Girdwell or similar companies who also use GLEDOPTO controllers, and then they just bundle a separate LED light strip. For example, there's an offer on in Amazon America at the moment, which you get an 80-inch light strip for around $47, which is obviously a lot cheaper than Philips Hue's own light strips as well. So that's option one, GLEDOPTO. Sorry, I won't. So that's option one. Option two is to go away from GLEDOPTO and actually get another ZigBee-based light strip and controller. For example, on Amazon America, you've got SLYVANIA, who at the moment have an offer for $44. You can get 3 24-inch light strips and a controller and some connectors. They call it a full kit. And that actually, although you've got three separate strips, you can connect them together, and actually you get a lot of flexibility in how you can configure things. And you can extend this up to $240 by just buying more LED light strips, but pointing them at the same controller. And that's quite a good option, and it works out substantially cheaper than Philips Hue's option. If you're not based in America, like I'm not, you probably don't have access to SLYVANIA offers, but if you look at Amazon Europe stores or Amazon UK stores, you'll see offers for ZigBee-based light strips from Inner and Ajax Online or AX Online and a few others. They work fairly well as well. They've got fairly good ratings. I know with Inner, they've got a 4 meter long ZigBee-based light strip for, let me check the price, £70. So it's 157 inches, 4 meters long, and it's basically the same price as a 2 meter long Philips Hue strip. So half the price for, same price, but for twice as much length. The third option available to you is to buy a generic ZigBee-based controller. Now, if you just go on Amazon and you search for ZigBee LED Lightstrip, you'll come up with quite a few different results. I won't bother listing them all here or going through them one by one. But what I will say, if you're going to buy a no-name or no-brand product, is just be a bit careful for things like fake reviews. There's a lot of cases where, especially on Amazon, where sometimes the reviews aren't all that reputable. So maybe run your product that you plan on buying through a website like ReviewMeta, which can show you whether maybe there's fake reviews that are not going on. And obviously steer clear of any products that have, you know, fake reviews going on. The second thing you want to do if you're buying a more generic make is look up the company and see whether they have any sort of online presence. Because although Amazon are fairly good at taking back a faulty product in the first few months, if your LED strip fails down the line and you've bought from a no-name company that has no online presence, you might be out of luck completely compared to somewhere like GLEDOPTO or Philips Hue, where obviously you've got a bit more recourse if it open to you. The third thing you should look at, and it's a slightly more technical point, is the cutting interval of any generic light strip that you buy. So this refers to how frequently you can actually cut the LED strip, as is probably signaled on the actual LED strip. And this is quite important because if you're running your LED strips under shelving or along a desk or anything like that, you want a fairly short cutting interval, because otherwise you might actually not be able to run your LED light strip. For example, some of Philips Hue's own light strips can only be cut every 12 inches. So if you run in a Philips Hue light strip under a shelf that is only 9 or 10 inches long, obviously you'll have a substantial amount of waste, but also you wouldn't actually be able to do it, because on some of the older models of light strips, you can only cut every 12 inches. You'd actually either not be able to run that LED strip, or you'd have to have overhang on each side, which would look a bit silly. So it's better to look at the cutting interval and make sure it's fairly short cutting interval, so that you're more flexible in how you can run your LED light strip. The final point I want to cover if you're buying a generic LED light strip is the color profile of that light strip. Now, this might sound a bit boring, but bear with me, it's actually a really important topic. If you've got a LED light strip, or bulb for that matter, that's just RGB, what that means is it has three diodes, red, green, and blue. And you can actually see this if you looked at a light strip. You'll have a diode that says R for red, or one that says G for green, for example. And what that means, although that's good because that can produce color, the actual whites that are produced aren't going to be as good, because you're going to be limited in terms of the color, the white colors you can produce, whether they're yellowy or bluey or pure white, just from red, green, and blue diodes. So what you can have instead is RGBW, the W stands for cool white, or RGBWW, the WW stands for warm white. And what that means is there's an extra diode, an extra LED for white, which whether it's cool white or warm white. And again, you can see this on an LED strip. So for example, I got W1, W2, W3, W4, and they're the individually numbered white diodes on an LED strip. And that's really important to have, in my opinion, because any white colors you produce will be a lot better with an RGBW or RGBWW light strip. You might think you're going to constantly set your LED light strips to bright pink, but most of the time you're probably going to have them on a white based color, so it's worth having RGBW or RGBWW. But you will have heard me say RGB-CCT. And what that is more at the controller level. It actually dictates how the color is merged or meshed together. So for example, once your LED light strip connects to your controller, this will then go off and, you know, you'll be able to control this in the Philips Hue app, for example. And with CCT, you have one color wheel. And in that color wheel, you do all the RGB, the color stuff, and you can also select whites as well. Is the color wheel you'll be accustomed to if you buy Philips Hue's own products. If you don't have an RGB CCT controller, so for example, if you've got an RGBW controller, what you'll actually end up getting in the Philips Hue app is two separate color wheels. One of them will allow you to control color, and one of them will allow you, a separate one, will allow you to control whites. Some people like that, but in general, that's not what Philips Hue's own products offer. So if you're looking for maximum compatibility with Philips Hue's own products, then buying an RGB-CCT controller is a worthwhile thing to do. But obviously that's separate to the LED strips, which can either be RGBW or RGBWW. So the CCT aspect is actually coming at it from the controller perspective as opposed to the light strip perspective. Okay, so if you're buying a generic strip, look out for those four things. The final option open to you is to actually build your own light strip. You may have guessed this is what I'm actually going to be doing by the fact that I've been waving around a light strip and a controller. But by building your own, you don't need to be a mad scientist or anything like that. It's actually fairly simple, and I'll be talking through it in depth in my next video. But all you need is a controller, a ZigBee-based controller, whether that's RGBW controller or RGB-CCT controller. I've gone for the CCT GLEDOPTO controller. And then you need a light strip, so an RGBW or RGBWW controller. And then all you actually do, you get the wires after you've run and installed your light strip. You get the wires, you wire them in on one end of the controller, and then on the other end, you literally just power it in. And that's it. It's a lot easier than actually, well, in my opinion, it's a lot easier than going out and buying a generic LED light strip, or at least it's a lot safer than doing that because you've got more control over what's actually happening. And it also works out substantially cheaper than Philips Hue's own offerings. For example, I bought this controller for less than £20 or less than $20, and I bought this 5 meter long length of RGBW light strip for, I think it's around £15, so around $20. So in total, I've spent around £35 or around $40 on 5 meters of ZigBee based smart light strip. So I've ended up with more than double the length for half the price of Philips Hue's light strip offerings. And obviously size does matter, as does price, and this is a lot better option. And actually the LEDs I've got on this LED light strip are actually, they're a lot denser, producing better quality lighting overall than Philips Hue's own offerings. So I'm getting more for less, and the quality is actually better as well. I'll cover how you actually do this in the next video, but for now, this video is wrapped up. Different options available to you for ZigBee-based light strips. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please click the thumbs up button and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.